Hello and welcome to Persevere with Christ. Today is our, what is it, 19th episode of our show. We have a deaf Catholic young adult here with us, Karina Crochere. I spelled it right this time. It's good to have her back with us. So, Karina, take it away. Karina, thank you. Today we have our reading taken from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. You have followed my teaching, way of life, purpose, faith, patience, love, endurance, persecutions and sufferings. Such has happened to me in Antioch, Iconium, and let me spell this right. Hang on. Lystra. Persecutions that I endured. Yet from all these things, the Lord delivered me. In fact, all who want to live religiously in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. But wicked people and charlatans will go from bad to worse. Deceivers and deceived. But you remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know from whom you learned it, and that from infancy you have known the sacred scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work. So now I'd like to share my thoughts about the reading. This reading is talking about how Jesus suffered and was persecuted, but it helped to bring God's glory about. In modern times now, you know, we have these protests going on and these fights for civil rights and so many things that are happening. There's a lot of awful things happening with divisions in our society, and it's hard to separate the good from the evil. I know there's a lot of different issues going on related to the police looking down on people in judgment. And at the same time, there's also good police officers who do show mercy and who show respect for people. Also in the readings today, it was talking about how the wicked people will go from bad to worse. The deceivers and the deceived. And I feel like that's applicable for our time today. People are taking advantage of the protests. In the middle of this Black Lives Matter, you know, it's like they're trying to take advantage of the moment and say, oh yeah, we help people and support people, but is that really going to produce lasting change? You know, I read in the newspaper today, Mayor Marty Walsh said, we need to listen and hear what people have to say that are involved in this Black Lives Matter movement. We need to hear the story of their lives growing up. That's so important. When we look at Jesus in Jesus's time, he didn't judge people, and I think we need to do the same today in our time. So those are my reflections on the reading. Father Sean. Good. Yeah, I think the importance of listening is so true. That really is the key for us, to have good communication and good relationships. Many people don't take the time to communicate well. They don't make the time. You know, instead they say, oh, we'll talk about that later. I'm too busy right now. And it's so frustrating. I wonder if the experience that we're having in this moment will serve as more of a wake-up call for all of us to realize the importance of listening. We see in Jesus's ministry here on earth that he always took the time to listen to other people. And we know this from hearing the gospel readings on Sundays at Mass. We hear all about the many times and the many stories that Jesus took the time to dialogue with people. Jesus is actually a really good model for us on how to listen. Karina, right, that really is important. That's what I was just talking about with the readings and the importance of dialogue. And I was talking about this with my mom and my brother too, that it's so important to listen. And we need to realize the importance of equality and not having some people be less than others and looked down on. And that's where dialogue comes in, the importance of listening and communication. And in my conversation with my family, we're talking about dialogue. Sorry, my hand's hurting here. It's just sometimes if I haven't signed a lot, if I'm not used to using it, my it kind of cramps up, freezes on me. So anyway, what I was saying, though, is just I was talking with my family about the importance of dialoguing with other people about everything. You can talk about your beliefs and your religion, whatever it is, just talk about it. Father Sean. Right, there's so much more that we can learn from each other by listening. We shouldn't think that we know best or that we know what's good for someone else. That's not the case. Because, right, like you said, we're not above other people. We are on the same level. Jesus taught that and emphasized that with his eye contact that he had with the people he was talking to. It makes me wonder how many families today take the time to have dinner together as a family around the table instead of spending time on their devices or being distracted and lost in thought. It seems like more and more people aren't taking the time to pause in their lives and spend that time with each other. And when they don't do that, then it makes people feel like they're not worth the time. When we listen, it gives people a sense of self-worth. Karina. One thing my grandmother and my mother always taught me is that you never stop learning. You'll always continue learning throughout your life. And even though I learned that a long time ago, it stuck with me till today in my life as an adult. It's really important to remember that you always keep learning. With everything that we're going through right now, We need to take the time to hear the message of other people that they're sharing with us. And that will give peace. When we listen, we see peace instead of violence. And we know that violence only makes things worse. As we heard in the reading today about those wicked people that go from bad to worse and deceive others. We don't want to live like that. We want to live with equality, and we don't want to show people that we think we're better than them. Yes, I understand what you say about when people think that they're better than or others are less than. It's really a missed opportunity because other people give us wisdom when we listen to their stories. When we hear other people's faith and their perseverance and their suffering, we can learn a lot from them. I think that with faith, we know that we can get wisdom from listening to each other, right? Thank you for your time today, Karina, and for sharing your wonderful reflections with all of us. I think it's especially important in this time. Karina. Yep, I'm happy to share with you. Let me know the next time you want me to come on the show. Father Jean, we look forward to having you come back with us again sometime. Thank you so much. Have a wonderful day and God bless. Bye-bye now.